what to preach, but took me to this portion of scripture, Matthew 15 and 26. Amen. Amen. And it reads, "And when Jesus departed thence, two blind men followed him, crying, saying, Thou son of David, have mercy on us. And when he was coming to the house, the blind man came to him. And Jesus said unto them, Believe ye that I am able to do this?" Let me read that. "Believe ye that I am able to do this?" They said unto him, "Yea, Lord." Then he touched their eyes, saying, "According to your faith." Let me read that. "According to your faith, be it unto you." And their eyes were open. And Jesus straightly charged them, saying, "See that no man know it." But when they were departed, they spread abroad his fame in all that country. I remember that I was visiting a lady one day in a hospital in Moultrie. And this was a lady that was really, really sick. She had been sick for a long time. And they told me that she was in ICU, and they had called the family around. The family had brought in some funeral music, had it playing all around the baby room. And so I came up, looked around, found where she was, and went in and saw how they were already preparing for the lady's death. So the Lord instructed me to write the lady a note. So I wrote the note out and taped the note to the ICU glass at the door. And it said, "You shall not die, but live and see the goodness of the Lord." Take it to the door so the nurses can see it. Take it to the door so the doctors can see it. Take it to the door where the family can see it. And sure enough, the lady did live. She did get up. She did like Hezekiah. She lived a little while longer to see the goodness of the Lord. Amen. We want to talk to you today on the subject, commanding faith.
All right.
Commanding, participle, faith. Let's talk about commanding faith for a little while today. Amen. Y'all know that it's been high and joy in the summer. And in the little community, I'm going to call this community Moultrie, that's where I'm from. If it hadn't rained in a long time, and they were getting desperate. So the ministers in the community decided that they would call for a prayer meeting. And they said, "Well, we want everybody to come to this prayer meeting. We want the whole town to come." And everybody came. Presbyterians, they came. Pentecostals, they came. They brought their crosses, and they brought their rosaries, and they brought their chalices, and some of them brought some oil, and they brought all these things. And they prayed to God. When they finished praying, then nothing happened. I said, "Nothing." Somebody said, "Nothing." The next day, little boy was walking through the town square, and he noticed how dry everything was. How dry the flowers were, how dry the grass was, and he even looked at a tree and saw how the bird was sitting there so still. And so he looked up and he said, "Oh God, we need some rain. Give us some rain." And as he was praying, commanded faith. Amen. When we look at our faith, we all know that we can stand some improvement in our faith walk. Amen. If you're going to have commanded faith, your faith should command movement.
All right.
Can I get a witness? God saying, declare it and prepare for it. In order to receive it, you have to make room for it. That's why they said when Jesus was coming to earth, amen, prepare him room. Can I get with it? Prepare him room in your heart. Once your faith speaks, manifestation has to follow. Can I say that again? Once your faith speaks, manifestation has to follow. Once your faith speaks, the command must be carried out. That's why you gotta speak it into existence. Amen. Say what you want. Mark 11:22 says, when you speak to the mountain, shall be removed. Whatever you ask, ask. Believing that you have it, and you shall receive it. Third point, I have your faith to command men to come to Jesus. See, what we talk about sometimes, it don't make nobody want to come to Jesus.
Must be in the will of God. Shop there, Mama Rosa, who's your
God told me